We'll start with the second sum for cantilever retaining wall. In the last lecture, we had finished the first sum for the cantilever retaining wall. Now we are going to start the second sum based upon the design of the cantilever retaining wall. So here there is a sum. So design a cantilever retaining wall of the height 4 meter above the ground level, subjected to a plane backfill along with the uniform surcharge of 10 kN per meter cube. Here the surcharge is also given to you, that is of the 10 kN per meter square, and the density of the soil is given to you as 18 kN per meter cube, and the angle of repose is given to you, that is 30 degree. View diya hua hai 0.6. Safe bearing capacity of the soil, that is SBC of the soil, is given to you, that is 225 kN per meter square, and the grade of the concrete and the steel is given to you, that is M20 and Fe415, and they have told you to design a cantilever retaining wall. So just note down the question, and after completing the question, let me know so that we can proceed for the solution. Yes, any doubts? Is done with the question. After completing, let me know. In this question, the surcharge is added to it, that is of the 10 kN per meter square. Yes, done. Question completed, all of you. So we'll start with the solution. First of all, dimensions of the retaining wall. So the dimensions of the retaining wall, we are need to provide the extra height due to the surcharge. Yahan pe particular sum mein aapko surcharge diya hua hai 10 kN per meter square ka. So you need to provide the extra height because of the surcharge. So for that, HE, that is the extra height due to the surcharge, that will be equals to the surcharge upon the density of the soil. So surcharge is of 10 and the density is of 18. So the extra height due to the surcharge, you will get it as 0.55 meters. Then you need to provide the depth of foundation. So for calculating the depth of foundation, you are having the formula, that is Q0 into Ka square by gamma. So Q0 is nothing but the SBC of the soil. So SBC of the soil yahan pe diya hua hai aapko 225 kN per meter square. And K is nothing but the active work pressure. Yes, can anybody let me know the formula to calculate Ka? Already in the last sum we had done, and also in the geotech also you had used the formula to calculate the active work pressure. The same formula you have to use over here. Yes, what is the formula to calculate active earth pressure, Ka? Yes, anyone from you? Mahfuz? Yes, 1 minus sine phi upon 1 plus sine phi. So the phi, that is the angle of repose is given to you, that is 30 degree. तो उसमें से आपको k की वैल्यू मिलेगी, that is 1/3. So you will get the depth of foundation as 1.39 meter. So depth of foundation will be 1.39. So you can provide the depth of foundation as 1.5 meter. So first of all, do up till here, then we will proceed for the diagram. After completing these first two steps, let me know. Is everybody had done up till here, all of you? Okay, so now proceeding with the diagram. After calculating the depth of foundation, you need to draw this diagram. So in diagram, as you can see, the total height of your retaining wall, the total height of the retaining wall is this 400 plus 4000 plus 1500, that is 5500 mm. As you can see over here, the depth of the stream. So the total is your 400, and as you know that jaise hi upar jata hai, it will be reducing to 150. So this we had considered it as 150, and again we are divided in the four equal parts, that is the first, second, third, and this fourth. And as you can see over here, this is the surcharge. That is, and because of the surcharge, the extra height is over here. That is HE dash. HE dash is nothing but the extra height due to the surcharge of the 10 kN per meter square. Then, यहाँ पे ये यहाँ का pressure रहेगा 1/3 into 80 into 0.55. 0.55 is nothing but the surcharge. That is extra height जो हमने calculate की है HE. So यहाँ का pressure उतना रहेगा. Then यहाँ का प्रेशर के इनटू गामा इनटू दिस टोटल 5 प्लस 0.5, दैट इज 5.55, दैट इज नथिंग बट द टोटल हाइट. सो दैट विल कम्स अप टू बी 33.32 किलो न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर. अगेन दिस 5.55 प्लस 0.5, दैट इज ड्यू टू द सरचार्ज. तो यहाँ के लिए के इनटू गामा इनटू एच प्लस एची, so the total comes up to be 36.3 kN per meter square. So draw this diagram, and again we need to do the stability analysis by considering all these weights, that is first, second, third, and fourth. just draw this diagram, and after completing the diagram, let me know so that we can proceed further. And if any doubts, you can ask. If anyone is having any of the doubts, you can ask. And those who had missed any of the lectures, I share the links of all the lectures up till now in your WhatsApp group as well as on the Moodle. So you can refer from there. Yes, done. Slightly increase your speed. Yes, all the others had also completed up to here. Okay. Now you need to calculate the overall height of the retaining wall. So overall height of the retaining wall, as you had seen, overall height of the retaining wall is the total height of the retaining wall. That is from the diagram. We can calculate it. 4000 plus 1500. That will be the overall height of the retaining wall. That will comes up to be 5500 mm. Then the width of the base slab. The formula to calculate the width of the base slab is 0.4h to 0.6h. H is nothing but the overall height. That means you can consider it as 5.5 meter. So after calculating, aapko milta hai 2.2 meter to 3.3 meter. So you can provide the width of the base slab. Aap provide kar sakte ho 3.3 meter. After calculating the width of the base slab, आपको क्या calculate करना है? Toe projection. So toe projection calculate करने के लिए again you are having the formula that is 1/3 into b. B is nothing but the width of the base slab. Just now you had calculated. So width of the base slab आपको मिलता है 3.3 meter. So after substituting the value of width of the base slab, आपको toe projection मिलता है that is 1.1 meter. Then after calculating toe projection, you need to calculate the depth of base slab. Again, the formula is there, that is h by 12. H is nothing but the overall height. So overall height up ki hai 5500 divided by 12. So depth of the base slab aapko milta hai 458.33 mm. So you can provide it approximately as equals to 500 mm. First of all, do up till here, then we shall proceed for the calculation of depth of stem. I hope all the others are also completed. And then you need to calculate the depth of stem. So for calculating the depth of stem, first of all, you need to calculate the lateral pressure in the stem. So for calculating the lateral pressure in the stem, you are having the formula, that is 1 by 2 into आपका स्टेम के लिए जो आया था सीधा सीधा डायग्राम स्टेम के लिए जो आपका प्रेशर आया था दैट इज 33.3 एंड द टोटल हाइट ऑफ द रिटेनिंग वॉल हियर यू हैव टू कंसीडर सो 33.3 इनटू द टोटल हाइट दैट इज 5.55 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 1 सो आपको लैटरल प्रेशर इन द स्टेम मिलेगा सो लैटरल प्रेशर इन द स्टेम इज डिनोटेड बाय पी सफिक्स एस सो लैटरल प्रेशर इन द स्टेम कम्स अप टू बी PS, that is PS comes up to be 92.41 kilonewton. Then you need to calculate the moment. So for calculating the moment, PS into total height by 3. So total height of the retaining wall is 5.55. So 5.55 by 3. So aapko kya milta hai? Moment. And after calculating the moment, you need to calculate the factor moment. Multiply the moment by 1.5. So factor moment comes up to be 256.4 kilonewton meter. Total height of the retaining wall is 5.55. Here we are going to consider the total height of the retaining wall, even though we are calculating the stem because the problem is due to the surcharge. As the surcharge is also there, that is the extra height is also there. So we need to consider the total height only while calculating the depth of the stem. इसीलिए हम टोटल हाइट कंसिडर कर रहे हैं दैट इज 5.55 सरचार्ज वाला हाइट हम अभी नहीं ऐड करेंगे सरचार्ज वाला हाइट हम जब स्टेबिलिटी एनालिसिस करेंगे तब ऐड करेंगे बिकॉज अभी हम सिर्फ डेप्थ ऑफ स्टेम ही कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं इसलिए हम टोटल ओवरऑल हाइट ऑफ द रिटेनिंग वॉल ही कंसिडर करेंगे दैट इज 5.55 क्योंकि हम सिर्फ ये बेंडिंग मोमेंट काई के लिए कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं हम सिर्फ डेप्थ ऑफ स्टेम कैलकुलेट करने के लिए बेंडिंग मोमेंट कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं इसीलिए हमें सरचार्ज वाला हाइट नहीं कंसिडर करना है यहाँ पे Yes, all of you are done up till here. Everybody had got the value for the factor movement. That is 256.4 kilonewton meter. Okay. So after calculating the factor movement, you need to calculate the depth of stem, that is DS. So again, for calculating depth of stem, you are having the formula that is under root of mu upon 0.138. FCK into B. So just substitute all the values in the above formula. The grade of concrete is given to you, that is M20. So FCK will be 20 over here, and MU just now you had calculated, B will be 1000. So uspe se aapko depth of stem milti hai 304.79 mm. Now you need to consider the effective cover as 50 mm. So DS will be 304.79 plus 50, so total comes up to be 354.79. Then approximately we are going to consider it as 400, and the effective depth we are going to consider it as 350 mm. So do this depth calculation, then we'll proceed for the stability analysis. Now we'll proceeding for the stability analysis. So for calculating the stability analysis, you need to calculate the resisting weights and movement. So सबसे पहले just go through your diagram. So जो आपने first part construct किया था, जो diagram ने आपने first construct किया था, that is your triangle. So triangle का area कितना रहेगा? Half into base into height. So total is of 400 और जैसे ही आपका stem का part ऊपर जाता है, that is 150. So 400 minus 150 तो आपका जो half part है, that is W1 का जो part है, वो कितना रहेगा? 250 का. 400 minus 150, so that will be 250. As you are going to convert it in meter, it will be 0.25, then into 5. That is the height. Into 1, into density, that is 25. So total weight comes up to be 15.625. Then distance of CG from the end. Again, just see to the diagram. Jo aapka starting se leke distance hai, that is 1.1. So 1.1 plus 2 by 3 into 0.25 as it is triangle. So 2 by 3 into 0.25. So distance of CG from the end aapka aata hai 1.26. And how you are going to calculate the movement? Movement will be weight into distance. That is 15.625 into 1.26. Movement comes up to be 19.69. Then second region is your whole rectangle. So rectangle ke liye again area will be 0.15 into height, that is 5 into 1 into density, that is 25. So weight comes up to be 18.75. again distance of CG from the end, that is 1.1 plus 0.25, or rectangle hai isliye L by 2, that is 0.15 by 2. So distance of CG comes up to be 1.425. Then second part ke liye again movement aapko milega 26.72. Then third part, see the downward part, that is your third portion. Again just see your diagram. So again wo rectangle hai, to kya aayega? 0.5 into 3.3 into 1 again into density, that is 25. So it will comes up to be 41.25. Then total 3.3 by 2, that will be 1.65. So movement aapko milega 68.06. Uske baad fourth part consider karo. Fourth part construct karne ke liye just you are going to consider that half part. See the fourth part, that is 1.8 again into height, that is 5 into 1. Now here density is your 18. So you will multiply it by 18. So fourth part ke liye aapka weight ki value aayegi 162 kilo newton. Then total, that is 3.3 aapka total length hai, minus 1.8 by 2. As it is again rectangle, so it will be L by 2. So wo milega aapko 2.4. Then movement comes up to be 388.8 kilonewton meter. Yes, if anyone is having any doubts in this resisting weights and movement, you can ask. So do up till fourth part. Is any query? I hope everyone understood up till here. Yes, understood or not? If anyone is having any of the doubts, you can ask. after completing up till here, let me know. Okay. All the other side also completed. Should I proceed further? Okay. So now fifth part. For considering fifth part, कौन सा consider करोगे? आपका surcharge वाला part. Surcharge is of 10. सरचार्ज कितने का है? 10 न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर. सरचार्ज इज ऑफ 10 किलो न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर. एंड हियर द लेंथ इज 1.8. नो नीड टू मल्टीप्लाई द सरचार्ज बाय द डेंसिटी इनटू 1. सो आपका वेट मिलेगा 18 किलो न्यूटन. देन अगेन सीजी, डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम सीजी फ्रॉम द एंड, दैट इज टोटल डिस्टेंस. सो टोटल कितना है? 1.1. सी योर डायग्राम, दैट इज 1.1. 0.4 plus 1.8 by 2. So आपका ये CG से लेके distance कितना हुआ? 2.4. Then 18 into 2.4, the moment comes up to be 43.2. Then you need to add all the weights, that is summation of WR, that is summation of all the weights and summation of all the movements. So summation of all the weights आपका आता है 255.625. And summation of all the moments comes up to be 546.56. So do up till here. Then we need to calculate the overturning moments and the weight. And if any doubts, you can ask. Yes, all of you are done up till here. Is completed. Okay, now you need to calculate the overturning weights and the movement. So for calculating the overturning weights and the movement, you need to calculate the pressure first of all, P0. So P0 will be nothing but half into base into total height. That is 1 by 2 into 36.3. That is nothing but the, see the, you had calculated in the diagram. That is for the length, that is K into gamma into H plus HE. So that is your 36.3 into overall height, that is 5.5 into 0.55. Uspe se aapko total pressure of the overturning moment milta hai 109.80. After calculating P0, that is the overturning weight, you need to calculate the moment. So for calculating moment, again you are having the formula, that is P0 into total height, that is 6.25 by 3. So moment aapko milta hai 221.445 kilonewton meter. So do up till here. Then we shall proceed for the checks. So first of all, we need to do the check for the overturning. And after calculating the overturning moment, you need to do the check for the overturning. So check for the overturning karne ke liye aapke paas mein formula hai, that is MR upon M0. MR is nothing but the moment of resistance, that is summation of all the moments that you had done in the stability analysis. So summation of all the moments aapko kitna mila tha, 546.56 upon overturning moment. Overturning moment comes up to be 221.445. So it is 2.46, so it is greater than 1.55. Your, according to your IS 456-2000, it should be greater than 1.55. So your check for the overturning is safe over here. Then you need to do the check for the sliding. So check for the sliding calculate karne ke liye, again you are having the formula, that is mu into summation of WR upon P0. P0 is nothing but the overturning pressure. So mu ki value aapko diye question mein, that is 0.6 into summation of all the weights. Summation of all the weights comes up to be 255.62. And overturning pressure aapko milta hai 109.80. So it is 1.39. Again, this value also should be greater than 1.55. So here your design is not safe in sliding. So first of all, do these two checks, then we'll proceed for the next check, that is check for the soil pressure. And if any doubts, you can ask. And we are having last 2 minutes, so rejoin the lecture again after 10 minutes. After completing the check for the sliding, let me know. I hope everyone understood up till here. Is all of you are done up till here?